Hello IP students, today our topic is plotting with pyplot and it is chapter 4. In this lecture we are going to discuss about histogram, and in this chapter we learn about histogram and how to create histogram using matplotlib library. So as we know that histogram is a type of bar plot that shows the frequency of numbers of value compared to a set of value range, and histogram plots can be created with Python and the plotting packages matplotlib. So the important thing is that histogram is basically similar to the bar chart, but the only difference between bar chart and histogram is that histogram contain a set of data, and the function used for this purpose is HIST, which belongs to matplotlib library and which is a part of pyplot interface. So if you want to create histogram, just write matplotlib.pyplot.hist. So in this statement, matplotlib is a library, pyplot is an interface, and hist is a function that belongs to interface pyplot, which is a collection of different methods and which is a part of matplotlib. So just write matplotlib.pyplot.hist. As far as its arguments are concerned or parameters are concerned, value of x may be an array, then bins, then cumulative, his type, align, and orientation. Some of them are default, some of them contain default values. So let us take them one by one. These are the key arguments. Bins, it is a basically a list of bin edges, and his type, it contains the type of histogram, whether it is a bar, stacked, step, his type, or a step field. Color, which represent the color of histogram. Age color is used to represent the color of an age in histogram, and alpha represent opacity. So and also x label, y label, and title are also used, which represent x-axis, y-axis, and title of histogram. X label, Y label, and title. These are also a part of pyplot interface. Now, first program is on our screen. This is first program. In this program, basically, it is related to default bin when we don't mention any bin parameter. Then what happens? Let us take line by line. First line is import matplotlib pyplot as plt. Now matplotlib is the name of library. Pyplot is an interface and plt is a function. Plt function belongs to pyplot and pyplot plot belongs to matplotlib. And import and as, these are the two keywords. Then there is a declaration of a list which contain different types of data, start from 15 to 53. So we can see that range start from 15 and goes up to almost 55. Now if you want to create a histogram, just write plt. And why plt? Because plt is a name of alternative name of matplotlib.pyplot. So if you want to use matplotlib.pyplot, then we can just write plt in place of matplotlib.pyplot. And if you want to use a function belongs to that library matplotlib.pyplot, then we can just write dot sign and after that name of function as second last line, given in second last line, this line plt.hist data 8. So data is a list and 8 are the number of bins by default. So histogram basically contain 8 bins. Then last point is plt.show, which basically show the output. and after execution of this statement we can see that color is blue, and color is blue because default color is blue in histogram, that's why color is blue in this chart. And total number of bins are 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So bins is equal to 8. We can directly write a value or can be assigned as bins is equal to 8. So number of bins are 8 here. And there is no X level and Y level mentioned here. That's why there is no name for X axis and no name for Y axis. And there is also title name is also missing because we don't use title here. So this is basically a very simple histogram, and default color is blue of a particular data set. So this is a data for data set. This is a data set contain different types of values range from 15 to 55, up to 55. Last value is 53 actually in this case. Now program number 2. Program to create simple histogram and orientation is equal to horizontal. So orientation is basically a parameter, and by default it is vertical, but if you want to give its value horizontal, then horizontal histogram will be appear on a screen after the execution of program. So in this program data is similar to as that of the previous one, but I think all things are same in this program. First statement is same because it is essential to import matplotlib library. Second, data is same. And why we take data same here? Because we want to change only orientation in this program, and here orientation is equal to horizontal. So plt.hist again, plt.hist, and then data, then data bins is equal to again 8. In last program bins are also equal to 8. Here one thing is changed, and this is orientation is equal to horizontal. So in this case orientation is equal to horizontal, and after this statement there is only a single last statement is plt.show, which basically show the output of this program. And after the execution of the program, this is the output. We can easily see that orientation is equal to horizontal, and rest things are same as that are in previous one. So only the difference is that orientation is horizontal in this case. Now this is program number 3. Here there is another parameter alpha, which means opacity. So in this case we take alpha is equal to 0.5. alpha is equal to 0.5 means actually opacity is 50% reduced. So after the execution of this program, what happens? This is the output. We can easily see that color is lighter as compared to the previous one. This is the output of the last program. In this program we can see easily the color is dark blue, and in this, since we take opacity alpha is equal to 0.5, means opacity is 50% as that of previous one, so it is much lighter than as compared to previous one. So alpha basically means opacity. So 50.5 means 50%, and 1 means 100%, and 0 means it represent clear, it basically cleared the data or not show any color when alpha is equal to 0. So this is the output of the following program. After execution of this, this is the output. Now question number Program number 4, program to create simple histogram. Here color is yellow, so here only the color is changed, and color in this program is yellow. And for different colors there are different characters. For yellow color there is a single character Y, so when we write color is equal to, basically we assign a value Y to color parameter, then color of histogram will be yellow. Now after the execution of this program, the output look like this. And one more important change here, bins is equal to 10, so we take bins is equal to 10 here, so that's why there are total 10 parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. And rest thing are same, so data is same as in previous question of program. And color is yellow, and last statement is plt.show to show the output. So in this program, if you want to change the color of histogram, so take parameter color and then assign a value. We can directly give the color name, or we can also write a single character name for a particular color. For example, for yellow color Y, we can take character Y. So this is program number 4, and this is now program number 5, program to create simple histogram. And in this program there is a attribute or parameter age color. So to understand this concept, first of all let us take the output of following previous program. In this program we can see that in output color of age is black, so default age color is black. But if we want to change the age color of histogram, then it is also possible, and this is possible using a parameter age color. And in this program we take age color is equal to green. And here we can easily see that program is same in comparison to previous program, but only two parameters are used here. Color is equal to Y. Color is equal to Y is also used in previous program, but age color is not used here. Age color equal to green, so we write G and assign a value G to age color here. G refers to green color. So G refers to green color. So after the execution of this program, we can easily see that color is green. By default it is black, but when you define age color is equal to name of some color, in this case color name is G, actually it is an assignment operator, so G value of age color is green in this program. And next, program number 6, program to create simple histogram, bins is equal to 15. In this program we just take bins is equal to 15, so if you want to change the value of bins, so we can write bins is equal to 15. In this case 15 is assigned to a parameter bins. So what happens, total 15 parts are there, so there are total 15, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, up to last to 15, so there are 15 parts, 15 bins. You can just write 15 डेटा कॉमा 15, और यू कैन राइट बेस इज इक्वल टू 15, सो बोथ आर एक्सेप्टेबल. सो दिस इज द आउटपुट ऑफ दिस प्रोग्राम. नेक्स्ट प्रोग्राम नंबर 7, प्रोग्राम टू क्रिएट सिंपल हिस्टोग्राम. हियर कम्युलेटिव इज इक्वल टू ट्रू. सो कम्युलेटिव प्रॉपर्टी और एट्रीब्यूट सेज दैट व्हेन वी बाय डिफॉल्ट कम्युलेटिव इज इक्वल टू फॉल्स. दैट मीन्स देर इज नो कम्युलेटिव एट ऑल, डेटा कम्युलेटिव एट ऑल. बट कम्युलेटिव इज इक्वल टू ट्रू मीन्स वैल्यू इज सम टू प्रीवियस वैल्यू. सो दिस इज द आउटपुट. वी कैन ईजली सी दैट we can get incremented value. Value is added to previous one, that is cumulative. So cumulative is equal to true means value should be added to previous value. So by default cumulative is equal to false, and in this case we write cumulative is equal to true, and that's why this type of histogram will appear on your screen. Next is program to create simple histogram to ND X and Y. ND means ND array means array more than one dimension. N dimension we can say that. So N dimensional array. So in this case we use two data set, data set 1 and data set 2. So now till program number 7 we use only a single data source, but in this program we use two data source, data 1 and data 2. So this is all about data 1 and this is data 2, data 1 and data 2. What happens if we write two parameter instead of one? Then first of all write two parameter within a bracket. If you don't put bracket, then there is an error. So data 1 and data 2, so there are two programs. So import matplotlib.pyplot as plt first line, and it is essential because matplotlib is a library, pyplot is a collection of different methods, and we can say that it is also an interface. Matplotlib.pyplot, that's why I use here, and plt is alternative name given to matplotlib.pyplot. After that, data 1 and data 2, these are the two data sets and marks in a list. So data 1 is a list and data 2 is also a list. Different elements are there in this list which may be similar or which may be differ from each other, but here we can easily see that range of these two data sets are similar, 15 to almost 55. And second last line, plt.hist, data 1 and data 2, these are the two data sets and passed as a argument in this function hist. And last line is plt.show, which basically show the output. So after the execution of this program, this is the output. You can easily see that there are two colors, green and blue. By default blue color is there when there is only one data set, but in this case, since two data sets are used, that's why to differentiate between these two, two different colors are used by matplotlib.pyplot. So this is the output of this program when two data sets are used. And there is also hist type. Hist type is basically very important attribute. It means that type of histogram. So there are different values for histogram, and in this example we take histotype is equal to bar stacked. So this is program number 9. It creates a simple histogram, but in this program we take histotype attribute and take value of histotype is equal to bar stacked. So what happens after we use the value histotype is equal to bar stacked? This is line number 1. Import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. So matplotlib is a library, pyplot is an interface. Matplotlib.pyplot that is used here because we want to plot a histogram, which is a function, belongs to pyplot, and pyplot belongs to matplotlib. And alternative name for matplotlib.pyplot is plt. And there are two data set, data set 1 and data set 2, data 1 and data 2, with a range from 15 to 53, last value 15 to 55. And when we use hist function, then just write plt, because plt is the name of, alternative name of matplotlib here, matplotlib. And then hist, hist is the name of function to create histogram. Data 1 and data 2 are two values, two data set values, two data set bins is equal to 8. We take bins is equal to 8 here. Hist type is equal to bar stacked, and last line is plt dot show, so which finally show the output of the code or this programs. So what is bar stacks? We can see that this is the output of this program, and let us compare it with previous one. This is the output of the previous one, and this is the output when bars, when we take his type is equal to bar stacked. So his type is equal to bar stacked. In this program we can easily see that after the execution of the program, this is the output. There are two colors, green color and yellow color, and there is only a single bar here. And in this bar there are two portion, green and blue, and there is a particular range for this. We can see that range of blue color is from 4 to 8, from 4 to 8, it means total of 4. And for green color it is from 0 to 4, so again value is 4 for 0 to 4. So in first case we can see that there is an equal portion for green color and blue color. In second case, green color and blue color is again same, but in third case it is not so. Green color mark with 2 points and green color you can say that belongs to 2, and blue color belongs to 1. And why it is so? It is because in program we can see that there are different range. For different intervals. This is a data set for data set data 1 and this is data 2. And when we see this data, we can easily see that from 15 to 20 there are 4 values in data set 1 and data 1, and in data 2 there are again 4 values. That's why in this diagram this represent continuously 4 and 4 ratio, 4 and 4 ratio. So this is the number of items or data set values found in a particular range. That's why this type of data appears. And data set is start from ranges 15 to 20. So we can easily see that this is the range 15 to 20. For second it is 20 to 25, then 25 to 30. So how many values lies between this range that represent by green color and represent by blue color for data set 1 and data set 2 respectively? So this is program number 9, program to create simple histogram, and his type is equal to bar stacked. So in bar stacked, actually two type of data sets are represent using a single bar. That's why it is called bar stacked. History type is equal to bar stacked. So whenever you take history type as a parameter and assign a value bar stacked to history type, so this type of data will appear on your screen. If there are three data sets, then another color will also be appear on the screen. Now let program number 10, this is the last program or histogram. In this program belongs to histogram also, and in this program his type is equal to bar stack, but cumulative is equal to true. So there is a small change here when we compare these two program, and in this program only the value cumulative is equal to true is there. And what happens after this? So after this, when we take in previous program, if we take cumulative is equal to true another parameter, if we want to use another parameter cumulative is equal to true, then output look like this. So actually it is a combination of cumulative parameter and his type parameter argument. So we can easily see that the graph is continuously increasing. And why it is so? Because we take here cumulative is equal to true. By default cumulative is equal to false, but if we want to take cumulative is equal to true, that means that previous value is add to next one, and this graph is going up to last values. So there is a continuous increasing of length of bar, and it is because of cumulative is equal to true. So if you want to change, if you want to make a single change here, after that cumulative is equal to true, output look like this. So these are the programs related to histogram. Finally, let us take a quick revision. Histogram is basically a type of bar plot that shows the frequency of number. Frequency of number means how many values lies between a particular interval, or how many values are repeated for a particular set of interval or for a particular number, we can say that it is a frequency. The frequency is called the values lies between a particular range, and for this purpose histogram, we can create a histogram and use to create a histogram, there is a function named hist function which belongs to basically matplotlib.pyplot library, which contains different parameters. First parameter which is essential is x is a data set value, then bins, and it is by default, if you don't take any bins value, then by default computer can take it, and then cumulative is equal to false. So by default cumulative is equal to false. Hist type is by default bar. Align means alignment, is it is by default mid alignment, and orientation by default it is vertical. So, there are some other parameters also, and these are color. So if you want to change the color, by default color is blue. If you want to change the color, then color parameter should be used. Then age color, if you want to change the age color of histogram, you should take age color, and by default it is black. And last is alpha, which basically represent opacity. So if you want to take data lighter than actual data, then you can take alpha value of alpha. 0.5 means 50% of original one. And so these are the different attributes, and using this you can use all of them in a single program, or you can take one by one. Here these attributes are shown in different programs, because if we take different parameters in a single program, basically then there are some program looks very complicated. That's why to understand the different terminology and parameters, different parameters are used in different programs. So now finally, if you want to create a histogram, then take all the parameters at the same time and in a single program, and a histogram will be created. After that will be very useful to you. So that is the end of this program. Thank you very much.